A lot of viewers have asked me, hey Daniel, can I remove an element from my video using Filmora 9? You can remove entire people from your video. Now to be fair to the ladies, you can remove men too. Stick around, I'll show you how. She seems way too happy about that.
Hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell to be part of the conversation.
What you want to do is find a piece of footage to use in your project and bring it down into your timeline. Now this may not work with every single piece of footage, but it will with ones if you know what to look for. In this case, the camera is very still and there's a lot of area to work with inside of that piece of footage. Now the way we're gonna do this is by creating two layers of the same footage. So let's bring down that same footage into a layer above the first, aligning it exactly the same. Somewhere in the middle of your video where the motion seems to be going on with the subject you're trying to remove, what you want to do is take a snapshot. Now I've showed you how to use Affinity Photo in some of my recent tutorials, and we're going to be using it yet again here to accomplish something I haven't showed you, which is the ability to create custom masks in Filmora. Let's open up Affinity Photo, and let's bring our snapshot into the project. Once you've imported your image, you want to go up to the upper left and click on Layer and add a new layer. In the upper right, let's make sure we've selected black as a color for our eyedropper and put it into our foreground color so that black will be the color that we're using in our brushes or paint tools. Now over in the left, let's select our paintbrush tool, and I'm going to bring up the width of this tool so it's a little bit bigger. Let's make sure our opacity, our flow, and our hardness are all up at 100%. And while we have our new layer selected, let's draw over the image of the woman or object that we want to remove. Make sure you stay a little bit outside of her body. We want to give room for any movement that she might make, but I also don't want to eliminate anything like the little green island sections behind her. I just want to remove the woman, that bit of ocean, and that section of sand. Let me color this all in to create a custom mask shape. Kind of looks like a cat. And once we're done, all we're going to do is turn off the main layer. And once that's completely black, let's go up to File and let's export this as a PNG or transparent file. And we're done. Now back in our Filmora project, let's go up to the Effects tab. Let's go over to Utility 9 and let's select the Mask tool and left click, drag that down into your top layer. We've now applied a mask to the top layer. If we double left click on that upper track in our timeline, it will open up the features in the upper left to dig deeper into this track. Let's click on the Video tab, and down below you'll see under the Video Effects tab, the mask layer that we just added. Now, a lot of you are used to the mask feature and the preset masks that are incorporated into Filmora 9. But one thing that you may not have seen is at the very beginning of your mask features, you have the ability to import your own custom mask. We'll click on that feature, let's find the mask we just created and bring it in. Now under your mask selection, if you scroll down at the very end, you'll see that your custom mask has been added as an option. Select that until it's surrounded by a red box and your mask has been applied. Now you can't see that right now because I have it stacked on top of an identical piece of footage. If I turn that lower track off, you'll see the mask is applied. But it's the opposite of what I want. Currently it's masking out everything else and leaving her in. So I want to make sure in the upper left in the mask options, I invert this mask. That way she's masked out and the rest of the scene is allowed to show. Now when we remove something from a shot like this, the trick is we have to know that we have something to replace it. This is why we've created another layer of the same footage underneath. I knew if I removed her from here, there was probably enough going on just to the left of it that was similar that I could move into that place instead. That's the real trick. Don't remove anything if you don't have something else to replace it with. So what I'll do here is down in my timeline, I'm going to lock the top track. I'm going to make sure the bottom track is enabled, and I'm going to double left click on it to activate it up in the preview window. Now if I click in that preview window and start to move the lower track, you can see I can actually move her out of the scene and have another portion of this take the place of where she was standing. Now it's a simple matter of stretching this footage out and getting it to sit in a way that we only see sand and water where she's been masked out. That's pretty close, but I can still see a little bit of the mask edge. We can take care of that by left-clicking on our track in the main timeline, going down to the video effects, and let's increase the mask feather. You'll see that footage start to blend in. Now when I rewind my footage and play it, you can see I have eliminated the woman and replaced it with another section of that footage that looks just like the beach and water. Pretty cool, huh? If you want to learn more Filmora tips, tricks, and techniques, make sure you click on the links that are on screen now or the ones I'll pin down below. Peace.